Stand by to fire main batteries as soon as we reach optimum range.
Scotty, we're running out of time.
Captain, I'm working as fast as I can.
You see, Captain, your effort is being wasted.
Mr. Spock, distance from the Romulan vessel?
150,000 kilometers, Captain, and closing very rapidly.
Stand by, phasers. Commander, you'll forgive me if I put up a fight.
Of course. It's expected.
100,000 kilometers, they should commence firing at us within the next 12.7 seconds.
Scotty.
It's ready now, Captain, but I don't know whether our circuits can handle this alien contraption.
Throw the switch.
It'll likely overload.
Throw the switch.
Weapons officer, commence fire.
Gone.
They have the cloaking device. Quickly, compute enemy course from last position and open fire.
Yes, sir.
So we'll come about 318 Mark 7.
318 Mark 7, sir.
Executing.
The cloaking device is working perfectly. And the commander has informed me that even the Romulan sensors cannot track a vessel so equipped.
Thank you, Mr. Spock. Cancel red alert. We'll let you off at the nearest Federation outpost.
You are very generous, Captain. If I may be taken to your brig, I will take my place as your prisoner.
Mr. Spock will have the honor of escorting you to your quarters.
Captain?
Commander?
Deck 2. It is regrettable that you made an unwilling passenger. It was not intentional. All the Federation wanted was the cloaking device.
The Federation. And what did you want?
It was my only interest when I boarded your vessel.
And that's exactly all you came away with.
You underestimate yourself, Commander.
You realize that very soon we will learn to penetrate the cloaking device you stole.
Obviously. Military secrets are the most fleeting of all. I hope that you and I exchanged something more permanent.
It was your choice.
It was the only choice possible. You would not respect any other.
It will be our secret.